Hello and welcome 12th commerce students. Today in this class I am going to explain one important question from financial management, that is factors for determining the working capital requirement of an organization. The factors determining the working capital requirement of a business. So what are the factors? Let me explain to you one by one. The working capital requirements of an enterprise depends upon various factors, and the first one is nature of business. In case of fixed capital requirement also I have discussed almost the same points. So the same points can be used to write this answer also, that is nature of business. This is the first point. Now, the working capital needs basically influenced by the nature of business. Trading companies have to invest much more in working capital than the manufacturing companies. Manufacturing companies invest more in the fixed capital, but trading companies invest more in the working capital. Working capital requirement in trading companies is much more than the manufacturing companies. So nature of the business is the first factor of this question, that is requirement of working capital depends on this. Requirement of working capital, much more requirement is there in the trading companies. If the company is a trading company, requirement of working capital is much more than the fixed capital requirement. Now, second point is size of the business. The same points as in case of fixed capital, that points we have used, that point we will use for this size of the capital. Now, size of the business. The size of the business may be measured in terms of scales of operation. The larger the scale of operation, the higher will be the firm's working capital. If the scale of operation is low, requirement of working capital will also be less, quite natural. Now, third point is rapidity of turnover or rapidity of sales. Rapidity of turnover or rapidity of sales is another point of working capital determination. That is, turnover means the speed with which the amount of working capital is recovered by the sale of goods. If sales are much more, sales are quicker, the gap between production and sale is much less, then the turnover will be more. And if the turnover will be more, the acquisition of working capital will be much more. So working capital depends on the turnover of an organization. If the turnover is more, working capital requirement will be quicker. Working capital will be more quickly available. So working capital depends on the turnover or the speed of sales of goods produced in an organization. Next point is terms of purchase and sale. Very important point. Terms of purchase and sale. If goods and services has to be sold in cash, in such case, comparatively small amount of working capital is required. When the firm is able to procure its raw materials and other needs on credit, it requires lesser working capital. On the other hand, if raw materials and goods have to be purchased in cash and sales are made on credit, in that case, large number and ample supply of working capital is required. I repeat, if sales are made on cash basis and purchase of raw materials or any other daily expenses are met on credit, then working capital requirement may be less. But if sales of goods are made on credit, that means cash realization will not be there, and if cash realization is not there, then requirement of working capital will be more, because purchase of raw material, if made in cash and sales is in credit, then huge requirement of working capital will be there. That's why it mainly depends on terms of purchase and sale. If it is in cash basis, it's good. If it is in credit basis, then it is difficult for acquiring more and more working capital. So this is another point for working capital requirement. Now coming to the next point, that is length of processing period, that is period of production. Period of production means the longer the period of production, the larger the requirement of working capital. Whereas short range of production process, there is no much need of working capital. If the production process is for a very short period of time, then working capital will be required low, because payment will be made then and there, and goods will be sold in a higher, in a speedy way. It should be sold in fast. So acquisition of working capital will be no problem, and little working capital is required to carry on the production. But if the production process is a larger one and a longer one, it will take more and more time, and then selling will take place. In that case, requirement and acquisition and procurement of working capital is much more. Requirement of working capital is much more. Now coming to the next point, that is business cycle. Business cycle. This is one important point. Why? Seasonal and cyclical fluctuations in demand for a product affect the working capital requirements. During the upswing, of a business cycle, need for working capital will grow when there is a boom period. But when there is a depression period, then working capital will also be less. It is quite natural. Seasonal cycles or production cycles opt to occur, and according to that, working capital will be affected, will be influenced according to the cycle of the business. Now, next point is volume of production is another point upon which it depends. Volume of production means if the production is undertaken on a large scale, large amount of working capital is required. On the contrary, if production is made on a small scale, then working capital requirement will also be less. This is quite natural. Apart from this, the credit policy is another important point. The price level change also. Rising prices would definitely affect the funds. Same, the level of activity will not be same. The firm may not face a severe working capital problem during inflation, but during deflation, the firm may face severe working capital problem. So, price level changes do affect the working capital changes. Apart from these, if you want to write price level changes as an 8th point, that also you can include here, price level changes. So in this way, many factors are there you can include, but I have discussed the main points over here. You can focus on these points and elaborate these points if you want to explain it in your answers. Apart from this, you can add some points like credit policy, growth and expansion, then operational efficiency, operational activities, many other points are there. If time permits and if you wish to add, you can add those points also with this. But I think these are the main points that I have covered today. So focus on this point and try to learn the answers. Till then, goodbye.